First, we have contents of this chapter, genetics, concept of genetics. First introduction, then history, then Gregor's own Mendel, then important terms, important causes, and last, genetic material. First, we come on introduction. Question arises, what is genetics? So, branch of biology that deals with the study of heredity and variations. Now we first define heredity. Heredity means the transmission of character or transfer of characters from one generation to the successive generations. For example, forefathers to parents and then parents to their children. And variations means the differences existing between the individuals of the same species. Now history. So very first, genetics is originated from Greek word. Genesis means to become or to grow into. Therefore, genetics is the science of coming into being. The term genetics was first used by William Watson in 1906, and Gregor von Mendel is considered the father of genetics. Although Gregor von Mendel is the father of genetics, but the term genetics was first introduced by Benson in 1906. After that, about Gregor von Mendel, he was Austrian monk and 1822 to 1884, this is lifespan. He experimented with pea plants. So pea plants were his study model. Now question arises, why he choose pea? So there are so many reasons, but the important reasons behind this, the very first one is they were available, they were easily available. Plant, pea plant can easily cultivable or easily available everywhere. They have short lifespan. Within 1 year we can see all development in this plant, and finally they have more number of contrasting characters. At least 7 pair of contrasting characters he observed, and he understood that there was something that carried traits from one generation to the next. He realized that in T at the time what he realized, characters are inherited from generation to generation, and he named them factors. So this is figure of Gregor von Mendel, great Gregor von Mendel, father of genetics. And he, as I have told you, experimental approach, he made experimental approach and worked for last 7 years. For 7 years he worked, and particulates hypothesis of inheritance. So these are 7 contrasting characters of P, what 7 as you see here. This one, flower color, purple and white, again position of flower, axil and terminal. Seed color, that is yellow and green, again seed shape, round and wrinkled. And pod shape, that is inserted and constricted. Then pod color, green and yellow. And last, plant length, that is tall and dwarf. And what he concluded, that if we cross, each time if you cross, if we made a contrast, if we made one pair contrasting character across, so in F1 generation we get dominant character. In each time we get here a dominant character, either it is a color of flower, either it is a flower position, either it is a seed color, either seed shape, pod shape, pod color, and finally stem length. So always dominant character appeared. So this is statistics indicated a pattern. It is a dominant and is recessive. And how, what will be the ratio in F2 generations? This shows ratio. This table shows ratio in F2 generations. Now important terms of genetics. The very first term is here, is gene here. Gene means a unit of heredity. Dominant traits. Dominant and recessive, there are two traits. Dominant trait means traits that expressed. For example, capital T is for tall plant and capital R for purple color, purple flower, sorry. So both TT and R are for tallness and for purple flower of plant. Now recessive traits, traits that are covered up. For example, you see here small t for dwarf plant and small r for white flower. Again, allele. Allele means the different forms of a gene that is dominant. Allele, capital T, and recessive allele, small t. So, after that, Punnett was a scientist again, and he observed, he made a square, and he concluded in F2 generation, if we want to know the result of F2 generation, F1 into F1, if we cross F1 into F1, then F2 generation, what will be the fate of individuals? Punnett disclosed the thing. Then how it works, suppose these are the gamete of male and these are gamete of female. So how pairing of expression of individuals in F2 generation he observed. Here you see in case of color of flower, purple and white, if we cross a plant purple and white, so in F1 generation we get all purple flower plant, and if we cross two purple flower plant, so in F2 generation we get three purple and one white. So this is because of this Punnett square. Important terms, again continue here. Homozygous means when two alleles are similar, for example capital C or capital P. So this condition is called as homozygous. Heterozygous means when two alleles are different, one capital C and one capital capital C and small p, or capital P and small c. So this is heterozygous condition. These two alleles are different. You see capital P and capital A small. Again, genotype means genetic constitution, that is RR or small r. So this is genotype. And phenotype means the visible expression, that is purple. So for capital R means purple, and small r means white. So this is the color of flower. So which we see, that is phenotype. And how these color develop, how the color constituted, that is genotype. Again, hybrid means when suppose this is Kepler is small, so Kepler from father and small from mother. So Kepler small is heterozygous condition is here, and this it's also purple. This purple is due to hybrid, means from different parents, from father and from mother. So this purple is hybrid. Genotype versus phenotype. So genotype, you see here capital T, homozygous condition, and this is for purple color. Capital P, small p, heterozygous condition, but phenotype for this is purple. Again, capital P, small p, heterozygous condition. This will produce purple flower, and small p, this is homozygous condition, and this will express white. So you see here three purple and one white. Here this is genotype and this is phenotype. So here ratio is 1:2:1, because capital P and capital P here, small p, capital P, 1:1, and in middle capital P, small p, here heterozygous condition. So that's 1:2:1. Here a phenotypic three purple, this express purple, this express purple, and this also express purple. Only this small p express white. So 3:1, and phenotypic this ratio is 1:2:1. Now important crosses in genetics. So first come monohybrid cross. Mono means single. So what it mean here? To study the inheritance of one gene pair of contrasting characters. One gene pair of contrasting. Contrasting means if one is purple, then another is white. So we have two characters, but these two are in one pair, color of flower. And if we cross these two plants, so we get one color here, that is purple, because purple is dominant. and this will height in F1 generation. All the individuals in F1 generation will get dominant. And again, if we made a self cross in F1 into F1, and in F2 generation, these are gametes. And F2 generation, we get three purple and one white. So its phenotypic ratio is 3:1, while genetic ratio is 1:2:1, one capital R, capital R, and in middle you see capital R smaller, and last smaller, smaller. So genotypic ratio is 1:2:1 as the gene indicate here, but the character which they express, which they show, there's three purple and one white. Now dihybrid cross. Dihybrid cross means when we consider two pair of contrasting character. In monohybrid cross, you see we consider only one pair of contrasting character. Here we consider two pairs of contrasting characters, two gene pair of contrasting character, as I say. So these two gene pair means first color pair, color of seed in case of pea plant, color of seed, and the color yellow and green. Yellow is dominant over green. So these two for color. And shape of seed, shape means round, capital R, and small r, wrinkled. So one pair of color and one pair of shape of seed, color of seed and shape of seed both. Now if we made cross between them, yellow round and green wrinkled, so these are parent 1, parent 2, and these are gametes. In F1 generation, we get all yellow round due to law of dominance, due to this law, we will get all dominant characters, capital Y and capital R, because small I and small r are recessive. So capital Y and capital R for yellow round. So all the individual get are yellow round. And if we made a self cross for F2 generation, so in F2 generation we get 16 individuals. Out of these 16 individuals, we get 9 yellow round, three yellow ringed, three green round, and one green ringed. So you see, we get here 9 yellow round and one green ringed. These are parental, and three yellow ringed and three green round, these are non-parental. So out of 16 individuals, we get 10 parental individuals and 6 non-parental individuals. Now reciprocal cross. Reciprocal cross means these involve two crosses that consider similar characters but with reversed sex. What does it mean? It means that suppose in one case, with one cross, we take tall male and dwarf female. So in next cross, we will have to take tall female and dwarf male. We have to reverse their sex. As once again I repeat, tall male and dwarf female for first case. In second case, tall female and dwarf male. So this kind of cross is called as reciprocal cross. Now back cross and test cross. So first we take back cross. Back cross means a cross between an individual offspring and one of its parent. So F1 back to parent, and if we consider dominant parent, so here we purple and this is also purple. So these are gametes, and ultimately in F2 generation we get all purple flower. You will see capital R, and two capital R small r. So all F2 generation in F2 generation we get all plants with the purple flower. So this is back cross. Now we take test cross. Test cross means a cross between F1 offspring with homozygous parent or double recessive parent, So as I have already told you, if we cross, if we made a cross purple and white flowers in F1 generation, we get all purple flower plant, and F1 back to recessive parent. That is the test cross, F1 to back recessive parents, you see here. So these are gametes, and in F2 generation we get two purple flower and two white flower. So we get 50-50%, 50% purple flower and 50% white flower plant. Or ratio we can say 2 is to 2 or 1 is to 1. So this is color of flower. You see as I told in back cross, in F2 generation you will get all purple flower plant 1, 2, 3, 4 you see here. And in test cross you see 50% purple and 50% white, 2 is to 2 or 1 is to 1 ratio mein, in ratio. So this is test cross and back cross. And here we talk about genetic material. So what is genetic material? Chromosomes are made up of genes. You all know genes are located in chromosomes in a linear fashion, and number of chromosomes fixed in this differ species. That's why individual of one species can't cross to other individual of other species, because the chromosome number are unique for each, and genes are located in chromosomes, and they are responsible for traits or characters in living beings, whether plant or animal, whatever. Now second, genes are made up of a chemical called DNA. So DNA and gene, they have a relation in this way. And what is genetic material? Genetic material means genes, chromosomes and DNA inside the nucleus of a cell. Genes, chromosomes and DNA inside the nucleus of a cell. So inside the nucleus there are genes located on chromosomes. Chromosomes are fixed. DNA, these all are in cumulative form called genetic material. So thank you very much.